Most of the nation's focus on personal protective equipment has been on healthcare workers in hospitals and first responders. But another group hasn't received much attention, in-home healthcare providers. West Virginia Tonight reporter Hannah Getz talked to healthcare workers today who fear conditions could worsen if they don't get the supplies they need.
The demand for in-home services has gone up because of the people not being able to get to the doctor's office for multiple reasons.
State Senator and physician Ron Stallings tells me he has heard from a number of in-home care workers saying they're scared.
The in-home caregivers, one, have not been able to be tested. Mm-hmm. Two, are going to several homes a day.
They are also struggling to get enough personal protective equipment to keep up with their caseloads.
Like I said, we've made our own masks. We've provided masks for our patients. We followed the CDC instructional. We've made it, bought the materials. My staff is dedicated after hours, weekends.
But with nearly 550 workers who go into multiple patients' homes per day, that equals a lot of PPE, which they are struggling to get despite caring for the most high-risk population.
Pam, tell me what would happen if your workers weren't able to go into these homes and care for these patients.
I believe that you would have a lot of people who would die because they depend on us not only to help them get a bath, but to get a meal. Help them in and out of the bed. We have people that are bedfast. You know, if we're not going in and taking care of these people, who's going to?
That question is at the top of Pam's list, along with where is the money coming into the state going, if not to them? In Charleston, for West Virginia Tonight, I'm Hannah Getz.
Loved ones in her home personal care and nursing says money is running low while its caseloads are up. That means paying overtime and also buying supplies to make masks.